this story of the banks and hedge funds is really troubling.
This is blowing up big time on the Bloomberg, as you might imagine, because it really goes to one of the nexus that we really care about and our customers clearly care about, which is how banks and hedge funds interact. You know, the gist of this story is that there could have been, the SEC is investigating, there may have been some inflated bond prices that the banks gave to hedge funds, basically in return for business. And we're not talking about, you know, sort of folks you've never heard of.
Yes.
The names that are checked in this story on the bank side, JP Morgan and Citigroup, and on the hedge fund side, Visium and Third Point. So, I mean, these are big names.
And now I want to emphasize, this is an investigation reportedly by the SEC, so we don't know that it actually happened.
That's exactly
but
right.
If this happened, this is straight up corruption to say, if you inflate my asset value so I can report to my investors,
right,
I'm worth more than I am, then I'll give you my business. If something like that happened, that would go to the very core of the banking industry.
Absolutely. And this is part of a long-term SEC investigation, as you probably know. Matt Robinson for us has been covering this just really well over the last couple years. And, you know, it involves very thinly traded securities, often in the mortgage space. And there's room to for some bad behavior.
What's the counter for that? Like if someone comes in and said, no, this is the reason why I might have done that.
Right.
Or like, this is why it's okay.
I don't
is there
know.
One? Is there a counter?
No, it's got to be that, as you say, it's hard to know what the value was, and it was a fair estimation.
Right, that it comes from an actual participant, therefore the accurate price, it's
that's
fine.
Exactly
higher
right.
price is
that's
fine,
exactly right.
Et cetera. Interesting, but I wonder also, how easy is it to do that? Like, how easy is it to manipulate these kind of prices?
Well, according to our reporting, it's relatively easy because they're so thinly traded. You know, I mean, these are securities that could go, you know, days, weeks, maybe even months without being traded, so there's no way to really check the market. It's this corner of the securities market that is really difficult.
But if you're